This is a feeder for our national team. I think from day one, you could see that the ladies are actually prepared well. They're ready to go. Yeah, it's difficult with the rain. It's not something that you can control. To see how some of the players adapted on those conditions, it gives us encouragement that we're moving in the right direction. I think this is, for us, this is our base where we actually feed from, and then this will feed into our emerging squad, and then we can take it from there. So far, we're very happy.
Well, the week gives us a great opportunity to see what we have in the system. Although, as selectors, we travel around the country to go and watch some games. But when you get together in a collective where they play a bit of strength versus strength, it gives us an opportunity where players get to play against your pro tier players, which gives you a better sense of what you're looking for and how you can measure these players against your top players. And when you come to a week like this, you expect people to compete with each other, and especially those that's knocking on the door for emerging cricket or pro tiers cricket. And you give us that opportunity to also then gauge where we have to go and where we have to bridge the gap within cricket to ensure that these players are on the same level as your pro tier players.
We've done well so far. Still long way ahead, tomorrow and Sunday. Big two games we have to play, but so far so good.
Yeah, it's been a testing week for us. Obviously, weather permitting, so we struggle to get on the park. So unfortunately, we're getting into a stage today where we're playing against Western Province, where the weather affected us a lot in this tournament. So today is basically a do or die situation for us. So at this stage, it's going according to plan.
Definitely, bowlers have become more difficult to face, I feel. Every team you'll find now has two or three quality bowlers that really make you think as a batter. Especially with the overcast conditions we've had here the past few days, it's been a bit tricky up front, and pitches getting a bit sticky and stuff with the rain and moisture. So it hasn't been easy, smooth sailing. Outfields have been slow as well, so you get in the gap and the ball just doesn't go anywhere. We haven't seen huge scores from batters this week yet, but I also think that has to do with conditions. But bowlers are bowling well.
It's actually much better. Women's cricket is growing, yeah. And we have youngsters even now. Samantha Shute just came into the team today. She bowled her 10 overs on the trot, yeah. So it shows that the standards are growing. And having South African players actually helps the young players to actually adapt to the standard that we play with. So it becomes much easier for them to rise up to it.
Yeah, it drops off to in a good way to the younger players. You know, we've got two, three that are playing in the national side, which is a plus for us, and it's doing good for us.
Well, that is important. Obviously, this is strength versus strength. So this is the best women playing in the country. So this is obviously a good judgment to see where you are personally as well, and as provincial cricket, and then to make that pool for the Protea women team stronger and stronger. So this is very good competitive cricket.
Well, we've always been to try and find the next best player, and it starts at under 19 level already, where we look at those players. And if you look at this week, most of those under 19 players are involved here, which give them another opportunity of showcasing their talent against the best in the country. And when you come to these type of weeks, with the World Cup in sight in November 2018, we also have a World Cup in 2020 and 2021. So when you look at your younger players and see how they gauge themselves with your senior players in the national contracted players, they might move on, who's going to take their place, sustainability within various skill sets. And when you look at those players, these are the weeks we have to identify them, and obviously put them through a program together with some player development plans to see how we can get them closer to the reach the gap with the other players.
Obviously there's players that we identify that is in the radar to see how they go about it, are they improving, because after this is 2 days and they're going to, we've got an emerging squad starting also there, and see how those players filter into that, because everything that they've learned from their provinces and what is that we require them to execute. I mean, we had a lot of camps building up to this, and they come from the season now. This is the back end of the season. So for us, I think as a country, we'll be very happy to see the youngsters coming through and how they perform. And also, it gives a lot of game time for our national players going into the busy year that is lies ahead now.